It has most certainly been a minute since I have been regularly sharing on here around human design, around all the things, and I've had a lot of new waves of inspiration that have been moving through me over the last several months, and I'm feeling a lot of excitement around how I'm going to be continuing to show up here, especially in regards to human design, astrology, Mayan astrology. But this video in particular today is about the sacral response, being a generator, and what is it to actually live by your sacral response. So I know human design has kind of like blown up in the world, and especially even a lot of like mainstream sharing and social medias. And a lot of stuff is really great. It's amazing that all of this wisdom and information is getting out there. I feel like there's still this essence though of depth that sometimes is missing from especially the generator strategy and authority, and how to navigate this world as a generator. And through this video, I'm speaking to both generators and manifesting generators, because although manifesting generators, you know, you guys have these hybrid qualities of like manifestor superpowers, at your baseline, you are a generator. You have sacral authority. And unless you're an emotional generator or an emotional manifesting generator, the truth of your power, the truth of your discernment, the truth of your decision making is always going to come through the clarity of your sacral response. Now, something I think that doesn't often get talked about with being a generator on this planet and having sacral authority and what it is to live by your sacral response is that it's not always the most convenient option. And it's not always the most comforting option. And it's not always the easiest thing to do. Because what I continually learn through embodied experience as a generator with my sacral center as my authority, with the channel of the beat, is that when I am really truly honoring my sacral authority and when I'm really living by my sacral response, it actually pushes my edges and it pushes the interiors of my mind that keep me in boxes of what should be right, or perhaps other people think is right for me, or perhaps society would deem as correct, or I don't really have a lot of interference from my family, but like, you know, what family members would think is correct. To actually live by your sacral response can be a riveting, challenging, crazy feeling because it doesn't make sense. And this is the thing, right? When we start reading a lot about sacral response, we can lose that essence of being a generator. The magic of being a generator is being in our bodies. It's being so deeply connected to our body's wisdom. It's being so deeply connected to the gut instinct, to the mechanical response of our body. Yet even if we're consuming a lot of information, if it's information that's not resonating in our body, it's probably not helpful for us. And I think that this is a really important piece around discernment and sacral response, because one of the biggest questions I get from my clients, people I work with, people I'm coaching, is, well, how do I know if it's a sacral response, or if it's intuition, or if it's fear, or if it's my conditioning, or if it's trauma? And I always like to take it back to my own experience and answer that question from how I've experienced it. So a way I can discern that it's a sacral response versus all of these potential other things is that, imagine it like your sacral is an engine, right? So you have this engine purring inside of you, and some things are gonna make that engine turn on smoothly, and it's gonna feel strong, it's gonna feel powerful, it even might even feel like a purr or like a vroom of an engine. I noticed that I'm, you know, and this is after working with human design for nearly 6.5, 7 years now, it's become such a part of my own like psyche, it's just really natural in a way. But when we start to build these blocks of awareness around our somatic response, our body's response to our environment, I think that's when we start being able to discern better. So now I know for me it's a sacral response when I feel like a purring in my body. It's strong, it's stable, it's energizing, it's exciting, but it's like it's strong. It has a certain resiliency to it. And pardon me, just ate some cacao, keeping it real. Whereas let's say intuition, which can be linked. It can feel a little bit more etheric, or maybe even dreamy or lucid. Trauma usually doesn't feel as resilient. When I have a trauma reaction or response, it usually feels more jolty and grabby. In my experience, a sacral response is not something that's like grabbing your attention and you have to do it or else you're gonna die. It's like, it's strong, it's resilient, it's stable. It's like, right, because a lot of metaphors refer to generators as the builders. So think of it like, oh, I'm so glad that noise stopped. The cogs of a machine, right? It's like building, it's working, it's building on and of itself, into and of itself. And I think a sacral response, you know, from my experience, it has that quality. It feels true, it feels natural, it feels deep, it feels resilient. However, it doesn't always mean it's going to be the most obvious choice or the most convenient choice. It's about listening to that deeper layer, listening for that deeper thread of what you know is good for you. And it might not be good for other people. It might not be good for your bank account. It might not be good for your ideas of who you think you are. But it's about listening for that deeper thread. And I won't lie, you know, I still can sometimes struggle to hear my sacred response, but it's not because the response isn't there, it's because I'm in my head. So let's talk about that avenue. How to know if it's a thought or if it's a sacred response. Well, where is your energy going? Is there a lot of thinking happening? I guarantee you, if there's a lot of thinking happening, you're already out of the realm of decision making. And this is where it's edgy, right? Because it's like, oh, just follow my bliss. Sacred response, generator, MG, I'm just gonna do what I love. But sometimes that can be freaking terrifying. And when you're hitting a new edge, when you're about to take a new leap, it's natural, you know, it's understandable that the mind may come in and try to talk you out of it. Or is that really true? Is that really right? And, you know, when I look back at a lot of choices I've made from sacred response, they were not the most convenient choices. Leaving countries, moving places, exiting relationships, changing career paths, opening up new offerings, expressing new parts of myself, talking to that stranger, some things were really discomforting. Yet amidst the discomfort, there was still, okay, there's something I want to share with this. There was still within me a deep sense of safety because I was coming from my sacral. And that sacral has a resiliency and a strength. So even if I was doing something that felt kind of edgy, I felt that I had the energy to see it through and I knew it would be okay. And I think that this is where we can cultivate deep safety and worth. I'm just realizing this is such a loaded topic. I haven't made a YouTube on human design in a year, so bear with me, guys. More to come. I'll be less scratchy on the next few, over the next few, hopefully. But when we can cultivate that inner sense of trust, I think that is when we become truly empowered generators in this world. Because I think, and I've experienced one of the greatest shadows of being a generator is people-pleasing, or seeking our worth, seeking validation from other people, or trying to put others' needs first so that we feel good enough and satisfied. Whereas actually, when we can cultivate that deep inner trust within our own body, within our own sacral, within our own decision-making, by walking out on that edge and jumping off and trusting, we cultivate this inner strength, this inner resiliency that allows us to walk the edge and keep expanding as we are being reinforced and held by our own trust. And it doesn't mean we can't have support from others. It doesn't mean we can't receive validation from others. I truly believe that's a beautiful thing, in reciprocal, you know, encouraging relationships and connections and all of that. But I really feel like empowered generators operating from this place of going for it, trusting their sacral, leaning in while building that inner resiliency, listening for that deeper sacral response, even if it's pushing your edge, I believe generators will change this planet. You know, and I was just talking about this to someone I was having a one-on-one advanced reading with the other day, which is actually currently what I'm shifting my readings onto. I'm no longer doing recorded readings, just the one-on-one, and then coaching and mentoring and teaching containers. We were laughing about how a lot of generators find out, and let me know in the comments if this was you. When you find out you're a generator, you're kind of bummed. You're like, why am I not a projector or a manifester or a reflector? Like, there's so many generators on the planet. But then when we actually start living by our strategy and authority, I truly think that, you know, for me personally, I am so glad I'm a generator. I'm so happy I'm a generator because there is so much expansiveness. There's so much joy to be had. There's so much creative passion to be had. There's so much risk and expansion available and continual, you know, elevations with their own peaks and valleys and plateaus, you know, of expansion and growth and creative expansion and then growth and then pauses and then growth again. And I find that that's something that's so available for empowered generators who have learned to cultivate that deep trust in their sacral response. And I think that generators can change this planet because when we're operating from that place of self-resiliency, we start to really prioritize our yes, the things that we care about, the things that we want to put our energy into. And think about it, right? If 70% of the population was putting their energy towards what they truly believed in and what truly lit them up and what truly satisfied their soul, this planet would be entirely different, right? And we're already heading there. But I think that there's a lot of potential. So if you're a generator or an MG listening to this, I would love to hear if you have any reflections below, if any of this resonated with you, or if you have any stories you want to share. And I'd love to leave you with one tip for listening to your sacral response. I'm going to give you one of my practices that I do, and I call it my intuitive walk. And I often do this when I'm feeling a little disconnected from my body's response. I will walk out my door. I will not take my phone. I will not take anything. Maybe a coat, definitely clothing. And anywho, I will walk out the door and I will just feel as if my body had like a weighted mechanism. Which way is it drawing me to walk? Is it wanting me to go this way? Is it wanting me to go that way? Up to that lamppost, up over to that flower, pet that dog. And I'll just fully honor where I notice my body's gravity drawing me towards. Now there's a difference, right? The head, oh, I'm gonna go left because I always go left. Or I'm gonna go left because I think that's what I should do because I just went right. It's like, follow the weight of your body. And it might take you a little while. It might take you 5 minutes to drop into it, but that's okay. Give yourself time to reconnect and build that relationship, that trust with your body's navigation. And when we start working with the body in this way, the communication becomes more, you know, active. It becomes more online and we can start listening better. So I hope you enjoyed this little video as I'm getting back out here doing the thing. And I'm sending you so much love from Mexico City. And yeah, would love to see you in the next video.